From Learfield on the Vermont Sports Network. Welcome to the Kevin Sneddon Coaches Show, presented by Milton Cat. Get equipped and get to work. Now, here's Michael Lehr.
Welcome inside Gutterson Fieldhouse for the Kevin Sneddon Coaches Show. It's brought to you, as always, by Milton Cat. Milton Cat, get equipped and get to work. It's located on Cat Lane in Richmond. We got a good half hour for you. We're going to talk a little Marty St. Louis with Coach Sneddon, preview Northeastern at the end of this, and also mix in a chat with Ace Cowans at some point as well. So, Coach, thanks for joining us on your Thursday.
Looking forward to it, Michael. Thank you for having me.
So the biggest news this week in Catamount country, really, at least on the hockey side of things, is Marty St. Louis inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame, first Cat ever to be brought into that conversation and into that group. I guess for starters, kind of, when did you meet Marty, and how has he impacted your tenure as a coach here?
Well, I first got to know Marty as a coach of Union College. Had to coach against Marty and Coach Gilligan's team, which I think you learn to have an appreciation for talent. And when even though there's often times where they're scoring against you, you got to look at them and say that player's special, and certainly hard to defend Martin and certainly Eric Perrin and those guys. But I didn't get to know Marty until I accepted the job here at the University of Vermont, and quickly became a huge fan of him as a person, certainly respect for him as a hockey player. But then to go on and see, what he did in the National Hockey League was pretty much the glory years, if you will, were during my time here, and the impact it had on our program. You know, everybody in the college hockey world or young prospects looking at the University of Vermont can identify with Martin St. Louis. And I think the best part about him is, he's humble, he's confident, but just a very, very likable person.
And so how does that kind of alumni network stay connected here? Is it through you or through the other coaches? Where is everybody kind of staying in touch with the guys currently on the team?
Well, it's something that we've talked a lot about, Michael, and obviously we have our alumni weekend this year, and I think we as a program and an institution need to do a better job of really connecting with the guys. I think we do a really good job with the local group. You know, we have a lot of people here, former players that are in this area, but we're trying to do more and more to bring guys back and stay connected. So, doing newsletters, having events where we bring guys back to campus, but also, things like when we're on the road in Boston. We had a nice dinner with Kevin Miller the other night before our Boston College game, and a chance to connect him with some of our alums that are local in the Boston area. So a lot of work needs to be done, but it's so important because it's their program. You know, it really is. And the more they invest from a moral standpoint as well as a financial standpoint, I think it brings them to a point where they're very connected.
All right. So listening to Marty's speech on Monday night, I couldn't help but kind of see parallels to conversations you and I have had about this program as well. So I'm gonna play a couple clips of it, and we'll talk about them.
Deciding to go to the University of Vermont was a great life decision for me. Mike Gilligan, I know some of my celebration don't look like that, but you taught me to be so humble, and I'm thankful for that. Roger Grillo, you taught me about the details of the game that I knew there was so important for me for the next level. Thank you. But the best thing about UVM was meeting my wife, Heather. You were always there for me, good times and bad times. And he always knew what I needed. And most of the time was just an ear to listen.
So the first thing that I pulled from that when I was listening was when I asked you about recruiting and kind of what you look for, and then the first thing in a recruit, you said it's about character, right? And the fact that Marty, who leads this program in all time in points and is a three-time All-American, went to three NCAA tournaments, the first thing he says about this group is that it taught him to be humble. Right. Why is that the one thing that he says on the national stage?
Well, I think because he means it. You know, he speaks from the heart, he doesn't hide his emotions. You know, you can tell how vulnerable he is in his speech and how much emotion is within him about UVM. And I think the thing that has always endeared him to this program is, regardless of all the amazing awards and accolades he's received at the National Hockey League, he never forgets his roots. You know, to pull something like that about Mike Gilligan in all his years here, what an amazing thing to say, that you taught me how to be humble. and you know the details of the game. Roger Grillo was an excellent assistant coach here and continues to be very involved in hockey. So his appreciation for where the roots of his hockey career. I think it just shows that he's got a great appreciation for people. And then you talk about character. You know, he's always got things in perspective. You know that the most important thing to him is his family. And obviously, a tough night for him. You know, not to have his mom there, who passed away a couple years ago, and I know that was probably very hard for him. But again, just he's got everything in balance, and hockey's certainly a huge part of his life, but not the only thing.
I think that if you didn't know Marty St. Louis as a person, that speech was really a great opportunity for a lot of people who knew him as a hockey player to get to know him a little bit as well, especially this last part that he finished out with, which I loved. So here's how Marty finished his speech.
For all the kids out there listening, follow your dreams. Believe in yourself. When it seems like all the doors are closing, look for a window and find a way in. The reason that some people don't reach their full potential is because they quit too soon. And maybe most importantly, be a good teammate, both on the ice and in life. Thank you, Mom. This one's for you. Love you.
That's awesome.
I don't know if you or I could really say much better than
that. You can. I mean, it's everything you want as a coach to tell your team, right? To face adversity head on, never quit. Be a great teammate, and no matter what the situation is, a win or a loss, be there for your brothers. And it's a big part of what we talk about, being a brother of the gut. You're a brother for life, and you have to make sure that you're always working on those relationships, and that's really what it's all about. And you know, I just think for a lot of young players, I mean, I'm sure he's speaking to his sons in that moment, not just all kids, but you look at even our guys, you heard it in Media Day this week, you know, our smaller forwards that are, you know, undersized forwards, to hear somebody say something like that, you know, when they've been told they're too small all their lives or they're not going to be good enough college players because they're not big enough. Like, no, that's not true, you know, and he's the one who's given a lot of people a lot of hope.
All right, Coach, anything else you want to add about Marty before we take
just
a quick break?
No, just a huge congratulations. You know, I mean, he continues to be a great friend, certainly a wonderful support of our program and our school, and you know, just so happy for him, and we just add another banner up in the rafters as a first time Hall of Famer. So it was an amazing moment and certainly fun to watch him.
We'll be back with the rest of the Kevin Sneddon Coaches Show, a chat with Ace Cowans coming up. It's Catamount Hockey on the Vermont Sports Network from Lehr Field.
You want to be confident that your investments are working for you. Wouldn't it be nice to get guidance to help make that happen? Hi, I'm Steve Gentile, a financial advisor right here in Morgan Stanley's Colchester office, and I could help you create a wealth plan and help manage your investments, even help you work towards a comfortable retirement. Give me a call to start your financial plan at 652-6007. Morgan Stanley Smith Barney, LLC, member SIPC.
The Lehr Field Director's Cup, the highly recognized mark of distinction in college athletics across all divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow your favorite team's pursuit for excellence in this prestigious annual award through thedirectorscup.com, USA Today, or at L Director's Cup on Twitter or Facebook. Lehr Field Director's Cup, the crowning achievement in college athletics since 1993.
Citizen Cider, founded in 2010 on a hunch and some good old-fashioned hard work, has quickly become a leading player in the craft cider arena. Citizen Cider strives to look at the bigger picture and focuses on being involved in every aspect of their supply chain, sourcing all fruit directly from local farmers and pressing the juice to create a true craft cider, never from concentrate. Come see us on Pine Street in Burlington. Our tasting room is open every day, serving a full menu and delicious local ciders on tap.
When it comes to floors, windows, and doors, you want the best in high-quality service and selection. You could roll the dice with one of the big box stores, but why leave anything to chance? The professionals at Able Paint, Glass, and Flooring have sold and installed miles of flooring and thousands of doors and windows in Vermont homes and businesses. Count on Able for expert advice, free estimates, and top-notch service from technicians who care. That's Able Paint, Glass, and Flooring. Pine Street, Burlington, ablevt.com.
We're here to talk about Monument Farms Dairy. A lot has changed since we started this family-owned business back in 1930. But one thing that hasn't changed is the quality of products at Monument Farms. We produce and grow our own crops, raise and milk our own cows, and process and package all our own products. No growth hormones and no preservatives. Just delicious, great-tasting milk. Folks come from all over to try it. Local, fresh, healthy, landmark quality from the heart of Vermont. That's Monument Farms Dairy.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Touch again, my holder.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Hey, short on time, shop online.
That wasn't that hard, was it?
Come to Handy Toyota St. Albans, where we treat people great and our deals won't be cheap.
Short on time, shop online
at HandyCars.com.
Brickliner's Custom Masonry and Chimney Services knows that safety comes first. But striving to offer professional service, taking better care of their customers, and going above and beyond the call of duty with every job comes in at a close second. Call Brickliner's Custom Masonry and Chimney Services, 872-0123. That's 872-0123. Brickliner's, the ones to trust when safety is a must. Call 872-0123.
Right now at Milton Cat, get 0% for 60 months on new cat equipment. Because we know growing your business isn't just one thing, it's a million little things. And we're ready to help. With expert advice, flexible financing, and industry-leading equipment, you can get the job done, day after day. Get 0% for 60 months on new equipment. Visit a Milton Cat location. Call 888-702-0073 or go to MiltonCat.com. Terms and conditions apply.
Welcome back to Chat with the Cats, presented by Milton Cat. Milton Cat, get equipped and get to work. It's located on Cat Lane in Richmond. We are here with last week's hero, Ace Cowans. So now I'm just non-hockey note, a general introduction for yourself. Tell everybody a little bit about you, where you're from, and the whole deal.
I'm from Beverly, Massachusetts, which is just on the North Shore of Boston. And I grew up there. I spent 2 years at junior boarding school in New Hampshire, Cardigan Mountain School. And then I moved on to Groton School, which is a prep school in Massachusetts, followed by a year of juniors playing for Islanders Hockey Club in North Andover, Massachusetts. And then another year of junior in Waterloo, Iowa, in the USHL. So it was a long journey, but finally here at U of M, and it's been great.
Awesome. And the fun connection between you and I is a fellow broadcaster, Cole Zimmerman. He'll love the shout out. You and him were in Guatemala together on a service trip this summer. Can you tell us a little bit about that? Because that's awesome to hear about.
Yeah, it was just an interesting opportunity that came up for me. I always wanted to do something like that, go on a service trip, give back, and do something different. I saw it as a great opportunity to get out of my comfort zone. And I met Cole there on that trip. He's a great kid. We kind of had an instant connection. We've had a great friendship since then. He's been following the team, following you. And it was a great trip and a lot of memories. And hopefully going to do something like that again in the future.
How'd you come up with that idea or end up doing that?
I found it on social media through the hockey world. The hockey world's so small. I saw it. And I sort of brushed it off the first time I saw it. And then I saw it again later on, a few months later. And I just looked at it and I said, I can't pass up on this. So I went for it, put in an application. And then I was in Guatemala a few months later.
Chat with the Cats here with Ace Cowans. It's brought to you by Milton Cat. Milton Cat, get equipped and get to work. All right, now all the random questions that Alistair got to do with everybody last year that I'm trying to mimic. If you could start a band with three of your teammates, who would they be?
Oh, that's interesting. Okay.
So it's you and then three teammates.
Okay. I'll play the drums.
Okay. I can see that.
Yeah. I dabbled with the drums back in the day.
That's also what everyone picks.
Really?
Because I think it's the one that you're in the back.
Yeah.
You don't have to do that
I know.
Much.
Yeah, exactly. I like playing the drums. So I think I'd go with, we'll have Brian Kelly be the front man. I know he's got a good voice and he can play the guitar.
It's been a popular answer
for
lead singer.
Probably Matt O'Donnell on the bass or as lead guitarist. I know he's been working on the guitar too. And then we'll go with Matt Beck on the keyboard.
Oh, I like that. That's a random shot. No one has said put Beck on the keyboard. I don't think anyone's had a keyboard in their band yet. All right, that's awesome. If you could have dinner with a famous person, who would it be?
That's tough. I think last time I said Leonardo DiCaprio.
So you already had dinner with him, so you got to move on.
Let's go with Barack Obama.
Oh, yeah. I like it. Big election, yeah. Right in the election
yeah,
time.
Yeah, I just think he's super interesting and smart, so I think it'd be cool to talk to him.
Yeah, everyone picks like somebody who's really successful because you got to pick their brain.
That's true.
What's your lucky number?
14.
Okay. Yeah, wow, sure. Sweet that you got it. How did you end up with that?
Yeah, so it's kind of a cool story. I was actually named after a hockey player, Ace Bailey.
That was going to be my next question. Yeah.
And he wore number 14, played in the NHL, and so I sort of wear the number as a tribute to him.
So why did your parents pick Ace Bailey?
My dad actually became close friends with him over the years when I was growing up. And right around the time I was born, they were pretty close. And my parents were trying to go with a unique name and picked Ace. And that's how I got it.
That's awesome. That's a great story. If you won the lottery, what would you do with it first thing? Answers have ranged from a car and all that stuff to Joey Cipollone getting a poster. So there's not a lot of pressure on this question.
Oh, that'd be tough. I don't know. There's a lot of things I'd do with it. I definitely spend a lot of it and give a lot of it. I'm not sure where. I've had a lot of. You know, you always have ideas where you're like, oh my God, I'd love to do that. But then you're like, oh, that costs so much money.
Yeah.
So,
what would you, it's hard to come up with really what you would actually do.
But there's definitely a lot of like, there'd be definitely some service related stuff, definitely some giving back to my schools and alma maters and then obviously taking care of family.
Yeah, so. That's awesome. All right. So if you went on a secret mission with one teammate, who would you take with you?
Secret mission.
Matt Bain just walks in and assigns you a random secret mission. You got to run and do whatever Boehner tells you to do.
I'll go with Jake Massey on that.
Hey, are you guys going guns blazing or are you stealthy?
I think guns blazing. Well, actually, he's got a little bit of both of them. He could go either way. So I think he'd just be, he's kind of a winner and a hard guy to play against. So I just think he'd be a good trustworthy
companion.
Yeah.
All right, cool. Well, just to wrap it up, what are your goals for the rest of the season and what do you want going forward?
Yeah, I think we just have to take it game by game, and every game matters, whether it's in conference or out of conference. We just have to move forward day to day. It's hard to kind of look at the big picture, and you want all the success right away, but I think it's more important to focus on the day to day and just kind of win games as they come.
All right.
So, yeah.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
No problem.
That was Chat with the Cats with Ace Cowans. We'll be back after this. Chat with the Cats was brought to you by Milton Cat. Get equipped and get to work, located on Cat Lane in Richmond. It's Catamount Hockey from Learfield.
Right now at Milton Cat, get 0% for 60 months on new cat equipment. Because we know growing your business isn't just one thing, it's a million little things. And we're ready to help. With expert advice, flexible financing, and industry-leading equipment, you can get the job done, day after day. Get 0% for 60 months on new equipment. Visit a Milton Cat location. Call 888-702-0073 or go to MiltonCat.com. Terms and conditions apply.
Life is filled with uncertainties. Your career, your health, your family situation, they're all subject to change. So how can you plan for your future when you don't know what it'll hold? Hi, I'm Steve Gentile, a financial advisor right here at Morgan Stanley's Colchester office. I'll work with you to create a wealth plan and manage your investments through all of the changes. To get started, give me a call at 652-6007 and start planning your future today. Morgan Stanley Smith Barney, LLC, member SIPC.
Guild Tavern, Williston Road, South Burlington. The Farmhouse Group's Tavern and Steakhouse featuring wood-grilled burgers, Vermont steaks, seafood, and more. Recipient of the Wine Spectator Award of Excellence and offering Vermont beers and signature craft cocktails. Join us at the bar for dinner and drinks before the game. Serving dinner nightly, located just minutes from UVM Athletic Facilities. Find out more at guildtavern.com.
I'm Jeff Bushy, sales manager at the Best Western Plus Windjammer Inn, Windjammer Restaurant, and Upper Deck Pub. I've been personally working with UVM Athletics for over 20 years, and I've seen some amazing games at the GUT. We wish Kevin Sneddon and the UVM Athletics the best this season. We're also proud to be a Victory Club sponsor for UVM Athletics and look forward to the continuing success of this program. And if you're at the game or plan to attend one in the future, I personally invite you to join us at the Upper Deck Pub. It's a great place to meet before or after the game. And keep us in mind when you have guests coming in from out of town. Go Cats, go!
There's just something about Vermont. It's more than green mountains and maple syrup. It's about the people. It's what makes us strong. No other company has symbolized Vermont's strength and independence more than Vermont Mutual. The only place to purchase Vermont Mutual policies is through local independent insurance agents. Vermont Mutual is the oldest insurance company in our state and also one of the highest rated in the nation. For your home, auto, and business insurance, visit Vermont Mutual online to find a local agent near you.
Hi, it's Matt Erickson from Vermont Paint Company. I just wanted to take a second and thank you for supporting our locally owned family business. We've been your first choice for Benjamin Moore paints for over 77 years. Sure, you might be able to now find Benjamin Moore products in other places, but what makes Vermont Paint different is our attention to detail, friendly personal service, and expert advice. We're happy to match any competitor's price on all Benjamin Moore products. Vermont Paint Company in Burlington and Williston or online at vtpaint.com.
The Learfield Director's Cup, the highly recognized mark of distinction in college athletics across all divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow your favorite team's pursuit for excellence in this prestigious annual award through thedirectorscup.com, USA Today, or at L Director's Cup on Twitter or Facebook. Learfield Director's Cup, the crowning achievement in college athletics since 1993.
We're here to talk about Monument Farms Dairy. A lot has changed since we started this family-owned business back in 1930. But one thing that hasn't changed is the quality of products at Monument Farms. We produce and grow our own crops, raise and milk our own cows, and process and package all our own products. No growth hormones and no preservatives. Just delicious, great-tasting milk. Folks come from all over to try it. Local, fresh, healthy, landmark quality from the heart of Vermont. That's Monument Farms Dairy.
Welcome back. Wrapping up the Kevin Sneddon Coaches Show. It's brought to you by Milton Cat. Milton Cat, get equipped and get to work. Michael Lehr here alongside Coach Kevin Sneddon ahead of Friday night's puck drop against Northeastern. It's military appreciation night for starters, Coach. Team's wearing the special camo jerseys. What does this night mean to the team coming up?
Well, you know, it's been something that we've, I don't know how many years we've been doing it, but I think it's a great way for us to pay respect and thanks to our military for all that they do to allow us to enjoy the freedoms that we do have. For us to be able to raise some money through auctioning off the jerseys, I think is just become a nice tradition that we've had here at UVM. So our guys are happy to wear them. They're proud to wear them. And it's just a small way that we can show some appreciation, as I said, for the military.
I know there was one year where Alistair couldn't see the numbers on the jerseys because everything was camo. So I'm happy that they're at least visible.
I think we fixed that problem
okay,
for you.
Okay, good. Yeah. Thank you. Appreciate it. It's all for me, I'm sure. So much appreciated. Before we get to the hockey stuff, we're not going to have a coach's show next week with Thanksgiving. So what's a Sneddon Thanksgiving like here?
Well, you know what? I don't know exactly. We're practicing on Thanksgiving. We play Dartmouth on Saturday, but we're giving the guys we're going to practice in the morning, and then give them a good 24 to 36 hours off. We'll get together again on Friday. It's a little bit of a unique situation in that we have to clear the building because of the women's tournament, so we can't skate on Friday or Saturday. So we're you know, doing some creative things, a workout on Friday, and you know, video sessions on Saturday to prepare for the game, and then we'll take off. So it's going to be kind of a busy time prepping for that game, but there'll certainly be lots of food, a little bit of couch time, watching some football and some NHL games, things like that. Maybe some volunteer work as well. We'll see what happens.
That's a busy couple days.
Busy day for sure.
24 hours. Do you have a turkey bowl? Are you a football? Do you play football in the morning on Thanksgiving?
No. If you saw me try to throw or catch a football, you'd know that I'm best on the sideline.
Did you see Owen Grant learning to throw a football a couple weeks ago?
It was embarrassing. Yes, yes, yes.
It was certainly tough. But hey, I mean, you got to learn sometime.
It's never too late.
All right. So now on the hockey side of thing, puck drop against Northeastern on Friday night. But last week, a couple of tough games against Boston College. One certainly better than the other. First question that I don't know if anybody asked you yesterday in media day was, how much did the injuries and being shorthanded affect you guys last weekend?
Well, you never like to use that as an excuse because every team goes through injuries. They're part of the game. I believe in everybody in our locker room. So the disappointing part for us last week was our lack of compete, our lack of will on Thursday night. We didn't give ourselves a chance to win that hockey game. You know, we're down a field goal first period on you know, goals where we got outplayed, out-hustled, out-muscled, and that's not acceptable. I thought we did a much better job the next night. As far as the injuries go, I mean, you can't ignore the fact that, you know, our top line is pretty much in the stands with Coughlin and Esposito. And the guy I think we miss quite a bit is Max Kaufman. You know, he's probably our best 200-foot player. He's one of our best killers. He's one of our best defensive players. And he brings a lot of energy and intensity on the offensive side. So, you know, we're looking forward to getting those guys back. But in the meantime, you can't do anything about it, right? You have to face that adversity head on. And, you know, I think we have the team in the locker room to do it. We just have to play a little bit smarter.
All right, Coach, now looking ahead to Friday night. One game against a really strong team in Northeastern. Yep. How has the prep been like this week, and what are you expecting on Friday night here at the
I think we've had a good week of practice. We've addressed a lot of things that we felt like we were exposed against Boston College because the game will be similar. You know, they're a very offensive-minded team. They've got a lot of talent on their blue line. I think Jeremy Davies is one of the best defensemen in college hockey. You know, they lost arguably the best line in college hockey. In Gaudette, Sakura, and Stevens. But guys have stepped up and filled those roles, and obviously they are producing. They're getting a lot of shots on goal. They're scoring. I said it in media day. I thought it was really interesting. I always look at where or when are they scoring, you know, and 19 third-period goals. They've been down a number of times by as many as two or three goals and found ways to come back in those games and either tie or win them. So there's a confidence that they have right now, a little bit of a swagger offensively that going into the season, that was probably the question mark. Can we replace those three? And they found a way to do it.
All right, Coach, thanks so much for the time. We'll talk to you in a couple weeks, right?
Okay. Thanks, Mike. Sounds good.
This was the Kevin Sneddon Coaches Show brought to you by Milton Cat. Get equipped and get to work, located on Cat Lane in Richmond. It's Catamount Hockey from Learfield.
Landowners, get ready for red-hot deals during Mahindra's Winter Savings Event. Let your Mahindra dealer help you save thousands on the toughest tractors and utility vehicles on Earth, like up to $7,400 in cash back and savings, only from the world's number one selling tractor, Mahindra.
Visit CCR Sales and Service in Essex Junction and Swanton. To learn more about Mahindra, the world's number one selling tractor, visit ccrsalesvt.com. Official tractor of Vermont Athletics.
Offer with approved credit. See dealer for details. Program restrictions may apply.
Hey, hockey fans, it's Matt from Zero Gravity Craft Brewery. There's one thing I've learned through my love of playing and watching sports. It's that win or lose, I always enjoy myself. But we all know that winning is a whole lot more fun than losing. I think the same can be said about beer. Drinking beer is usually fun, but drinking really good beer is a whole lot more fun. Just like winning. You follow? Give Zero Gravity a try, and let's keep winning together. Cheers from Zero Gravity. And remember, please enjoy responsibly. Go Cats.
Have you been thinking about electric car charging stations for your place of business? Cummings Electric can show you how to get up to 80% off the total cost of purchasing and installing an electric car charging station with a grant from the state of Vermont. Cummings Electric is your local authorized charge point dealer in Vermont. And now is the time to give Glenn a call and learn more about grant money currently available. Call Cummings Electric today at 802-658-1292 to learn more.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Touch again, my holder.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Hey, short on time, shop online.
That wasn't that hard, was it?
Come to Handy Toyota in St. Albans, where we treat people great and our deals won't be cheap.
Short on time, shop online
at HandyCars.com.
From Learfield on the Vermont Sports Network, this has been the Kevin Sneddon Coaches Show, presented by Milton Cat. Get equipped and get to work. The preceding has been a Learfield presentation on the Vermont Sports Network.